What are you doing out here? Shouldn't you be recovering from your injury?
Maybe I'm just plotting the best way to betray you again.
At this point, I can't tell if you're joking.
Ooh, ouch. That's a low blow.
Drop the phony indignation. Tell me, what are your true intentions?
We went over this already. I want to take care of my mother.
And I believed you at first. Now, not so much.
Why?
You haven't severed all ties with Exodus. And yet you've never attempted to assassinate me like the other Exodus agents.
Maybe the opportunity never presented itself. Maybe I'm plotting your hit right now. That's it? You're not even gonna get mad or anything?
Being murdered would be unfortunate. I wouldn't be able to protect this world anymore.
Unfortunate indeed. Then get out of my face and you won't have to worry about me killing you. Truly are Maxwell, through and through.
I never thought we'd end up back here again. It seems like forever ago that you were injured.
Have you figured out your mission? What you must do?
I just want to help you out.
I see.
But that's not all. I want to protect the spirits as well. You go to such lengths to protect humans. So it's only fair that I become strong enough to protect spirits too.
You will strive to be our protector. A bold statement. Maybe I've been wrong about humans after all. I never imagined one of you wanting to protect our kind, let alone making it his mission. I'm almost speechless. I've never felt this happy. Now I really must destroy the Lance of Kresnik, for all our sakes.
That reminds me. What are you planning on doing after you've destroyed the Lance?
Destroying the Lance and the Spyrex devices is merely one facet of my mission here. My whole reason for existing hasn't changed.
So you'll return to Nia Kara and live the way you did before?
Most likely.
But with Exodus around, won't your life still be in danger?
Also likely.
What you need is a bodyguard, someone to watch your back.
Are you offering to stay with me?
Is that possible?
If that's what you decide to do, then you should do it. I'll need to create some story to keep you by my side.
Really? Thank you.
It's the least I can do. You're the reason I'm standing here right now, preparing to fulfill my mission. I'm the one who should be thanking you.
Huh? Oh, no, you don't have to do that. We haven't even gotten to the real fight yet.
Good point.
Oh, just the pair I was looking for. Your wyverns have fully recovered.
Let's return to the plaza.
Okay. Where's Alvin?
He hasn't shown up yet. He's probably figuring out his next lie.
That's not true.
What does everyone else think of Alvin? Would you feel safe going into battle with him?
He's just trying to help out his mom, right? I'm a sucker for that kind of stuff.
I worry he himself will be unable to deal with that way of life much longer.
Don't forget, Alvin was the one who saved me from the bad guys.
What do you think?
We'll need to keep up our guard around him until he reveals his hand. He remains trustworthy in battle, at least.
No, it's not polite to talk about someone behind his back.
I don't care.
What can I say? You guys are my only allies.
That makes everyone. Let's be off.
Please wait!
Rowan, are you really gonna fight with your old buddy?
It is my fault that Noctegaal became the man he is. I am prepared to fight him when the time comes.
You have our support.
Don't worry, I'll be right behind you.
I've got your back, too!
Thank you, everyone.
Don't worry, I'll pick up your dentures if you drop them, Grandpa.
Please do.
What, no pithy retort?
I guess that means we're all ready.
Let's make our final preparations before setting off. Thank you for everything.
Please return home safely. For my brother as well.
You have my word, young madam.
Then let's be off. I believe we just need to follow this road to reach Fenmont.
Yeah, let's go. What's going on?
Hey, look!
Isn't that...
the lab!
The Lance of Kresnik is in there. Let's go.
What are spirits? You could say they're an invisible presence that permeates our entire world. You could say they're the font of spirit arts, feeding off the mana from human mana lobes. You could say they're the guiding hand that turns the wheel of all existence in res maxima. In other words, the symbiotic relationship between human and spirit is at the core of every facet of our lives. But we don't know when this relationship began. How did humans and spirits relate before our modern spirit art culture? What was the world like then? Ah, it's hopeless. Once again, the sun is setting without any answers in sight.
This is Fenmont? The sun never rises. Are you okay? Mr. Eldon?
Doc. Dr. Jude?
Lie still. You're hurt pretty badly.
Listen to me, Doc. She tricked us. One of the researchers was actually an Azhul spy. When I tried to arrest her, she blew up the entire testing chamber.
We'll carry the wounded to the hospital. Come with me.
It sounds like Gaius is making his move.
We can't waste any more time.
Now what? Doesn't sound like knocking will get us in.
The Lance of Kresnik is just beyond this door.
There's got to be another way in. Let's look for it. What was that?
What?
You okay?
I don't know anything. I'm sorry.
Isn't she?
It's the mayor! Hang in there!
The mayor of Hamil? They did say that the Rashagal army invaded the village.
All the villagers froze and solid. No! No!
Hey, come back to us. Don't give up.
Oh no! Mayor!
It's Professor House all over again.
The villagers were frozen solid? What could that mean? Is this what Gaius's henchwoman meant when she said the power of a great spirit?
This woman was knocking on death's door. She might have been delusional.
Either way, this is unforgivable.
I wonder if it'll work the same.
Can this contraption help us?
It might let us look in on the lance. Here's the video feed.
That's remarkable, Jude.
There's nothing there.
Huh?
The lance of Kresnik is gone. Did that explosion destroy it?
Surely it would leave some wreckage behind.
Perhaps the lance was moved before the explosion occurred. That's the only logical explanation.
But moved to where?
Mila, look! I found a recording of what happened. Is that the spy Mr. Eldon talked about?
That girl. She's the one from our last visit.
You're right. She was the one that attacked us.
Hey, what she got there?
It looks like someone discovered her ruse, so she detonated a bomb.
But isn't she a Najul spy? If I were in her shoes, I wouldn't risk my life like that even if my cover was blown. In the game of espionage, a dead body can still provide valuable intel.
Then how about this? Maybe she planned to blow up the lance all along, and Mr. Eldon finding her was just a coincidence.
If Jude's theory is true, then it's likely that the girl didn't know the lance had left the facility.
That means she's now either on her way to the location where the lance was taken,
or trying to find out where that location is.
In either case, we might find out something if we can catch her.
According to the timestamp on the video, the explosion only happened half an hour ago.
Then she's probably still in the city.
We need to find that girl. There she is, the girl in red.
I know you. Yes, yes, yes! I finally get to finish you off! And it's not even my birthday.
Sorry to interrupt your little psychotic episode, but we really need to ask you something.
Why would I answer you, Claude?
Wait, I have seen you before. Is it possible? Are you Lady Nadia of House Travis?
Huh?
I seem to be correct. But what would compel an heiress of one of the six ruling houses to spy for Azul?
I don't know anything about that stinking house. I'm Agria the Shadowless of the Chimeriad.
The Chimeriad again?
So you're working for Gaius.
What's it to you?
You tried to destroy the Lance of Kresnik.
Well, duh.
We want to destroy it too. That makes us allies. If you know where the lance was taken, tell us.
Like I'd tell you anything.
Please, you want to destroy it for the same reason we do, right? Because it's dangerous?
You reek. Oh, I've got an idea. Before I destroy the lance, I'll use it to blast Rashigul to itty-bitty bits!
What is your problem? We're working our butts off to save the world, and you think it's funny to stand in our way?
You really do stink!
What are you, five?
You think you can fill the world with rainbows and kittens just by working hard? That sweet reek of yours is giving me brain decay!
What's your beef with hard work?
Zip it, you little pimple, or I'll pop you!
Excuse me?
I still remember the agony you caused me that day!
This girl is making my head hurt.
You seriously stink.
What the hell?
Stand in our way and we'll be forced to cut you down.
Whatever. It's time we got rid of the damn stink around here.
Snap over.
You're pathetic.
Okay.
Ruination phase!
You have to be kidding me.
What's wrong?
Mila, I don't stink, do I?
No, you're totally fine.
Did I ask you?
I should warn you, I'm still not used to the sensation of sweating during exertion. Couple that with my somewhat clumsy sword grip, and well, you might consider being a little more cooperative. Where is the lance?
A secret passageway runs under the laboratory. It connects to Orta Palace.
And that is?
That's the palace Noctigal rules from.
I've never heard of this passageway.
Is it still usable?
Only if you're a worm. It's caved in now.
So we can't use it.
Hey, get back here!
Maxwell, one of these days, I'm going to rip that pretty face of yours to pieces! And you, pimple, listen up. Work, work, work as hard as that scrawny body of yours can handle, and you'll still wind up with only two things, Jack and Squat!
Why do you say stuff like that? That girl has serious issues.
Orta Palace, the enemy stronghold.
We should be careful.
I know. Let's check things out first.
Dr. Jude, I didn't know you were back. I couldn't believe it when I heard that the military was after you. Oh gosh, where do I even begin?
Take a deep breath, Prin. It's okay. Although, to be honest, so much has happened that I don't really know where to begin either.
You weren't really a spy, were you? I can't imagine you being one.
Are you kidding? Jude's smart and all, but I wouldn't hire this goofball to spy on his own nose.
A harsh yet accurate appraisal.
You must be Leia. You're exactly as Dr. Jude described you. You always showed up in his stories, you know.
Really? And here I thought he'd forgotten all about me.
I only mentioned you a few times. Hey, is that a Sylph-Jay? Are you treating it?
Yes, I'm doing it as a special favor for an acquaintance of mine.
That's the same bird Alvin uses. I didn't know it was called a Sylph-Jay.
They're pretty unique. They can channel wind spirits with their manalobe to help them fly long distances.
Sylph-Jays also have the ability to distinguish between the manalobes of different people and can use that to sense a person's location. Hence their popular use for military communication.
Wow, little guy, you're pretty smart.
Unfortunately, this little one flew too far, too fast, and ended up hurting his manalobe.
Well, that was silly of you. But I like a hard worker.
He'll weaken and die from the injury, and there isn't anything I can do to save him. There is a treatment that uses harmonica grass, but it's impossible to get right now with everything that's happening.
Hey, if that's the case, I'll find some harmonica grass for him.
What?
You know I have a weakness for the smart but bumbling type.
You're still talking about the Sylph Jay, right?
What?
Our mission is finally over and there still isn't anything you can do?
Please calm down, Lady Nadia. My friends will be back with harmonica grass for him soon.
Blah, blah, friends, this, grass, that. Don't you get it? We need to get out of here.
We got the harmonica grass.
The hell?
Agria, what are you doing here?
These your so-called friends?
Yes.
This is classic.
How do you know Prin?
Because she's the liaison for us Azul spies.
Lady Nadia?
Ah, who cares? These chumps don't have the balls to rat you out. Prin's job is to pass all the juicy information I collect back to Azul.
Is that true?
It is.
And this Sylph Jay was your means of communication?
No way.
How does that feel, Pimple? How does it feel to know you tried your very best to help an enemy spy? Phew! Not only do you stink of hypocrisy, you reek of stupidity, too!
What?
Leia!
I'd stay back if I were you. Wouldn't want to get my stench of stupidity on you.
Come on.
Excuse me. I just wanted to thank you for all your help. If you hadn't brought the harmonica grass, Bobo would have died. Now he's going to be fine.
Tell me, do you have some connection to Agri... rather, Nadia's family in House Travis?
I do. My mother was her nanny. I've known her since she was a baby.
So Agria really is nobility.
Sadly, Miss Nadia's mother was a commoner, and she was subjected to much abuse because of it.
The Travis family has always been focused on privilege, even by the standards of the 6 ruling houses.
Eventually, Nadia's mother, the only support Nadia had, became estranged from the Travis family leaders. She died shortly after, and Nadia was convinced they had conspired to kill her.
Is that why she became a spy for Azul?
It's no excuse for selling out her country, but...
Who could blame her at that point?
I suppose what Rashagal was doing would be unacceptable in any country.
Prin, is Bobo the name of that Sylph Jay?
Yes, Miss Nadia named him herself. She's been taking care of him since he was an egg. She's always loved him.
I see. Thank goodness he's okay. Even if Agria did laugh at me, I'm glad that Bobo's all right.
Yeah, we all are.
You really are exactly how Dr. Ju described you, Leia.
Indeed. She inspires smiles wherever she goes.
Huh. I figured security would be tighter than this.
I don't suppose we could just charge inside.
That wouldn't be prudent. This is their stronghold.
Rowan? What's the matter?
I was just weighing options. I think Jude might have the right idea here.
Whoa, hey now, are you serious? For once, Mila's telling us to be cautious and not charge in.
Do you have a plan?
More of a hunch, actually. Shall we test it?
If it's good enough for Rowan, count me in.
Stop right there!
I will fulfill my mission, no matter what happens.
I'm right. Any reinforcements?
Looks clear. But this is the King's house. Shouldn't he have more soldiers?
It could be a trap.
No doubt the Rashagal army has already been deployed for war with Azul.
But wouldn't they tighten security around the royal palace in wartime?
Except for the natural and man-made barriers that protect Fenmont in the north and south, it has few defenses in the event of a siege. If the enemy army breaches its walls, the city is as good as fallen. Troops are wasted here in wartime, so the majority of them are deployed to fortify the naval defenses in Fort Gondala.
That makes sense. But it also means war is imminent. We can't waste this opportunity.
Indeed. This is a Lotus Ring, a device that ferries people throughout Order Palace. We must use it to proceed further.
All aboard?
It appears some rats have snuck into the palace. They should be here any moment.
Who are these vermin? I needn't have asked. So you've arrived, Maxwell. And looking much more spry than I expected after your injury.
All to stop you.
Go wait by the lance. We'll obliterate those northern savages as soon as I'm finished with Maxwell.
As you wish.
Ilbert, will you really raise your sword against your master?
My only master is Lord Klein. There is no other.
I'm willing to forgive such insolence, if you return to my side.
Once I thought you had the potential to be a great king, but now I see you've become unworthy of the throne.
No one in this world is more worthy to sit upon this throne than I!
You still don't get it, do you? You lack the qualities needed to govern humanity.
Foolish girl. A king only needs one quality, birthright. He is born into his power.
So he can sacrifice his own people?
Of course. Again, that is my birthright. Now I'll extend my influence over the spirit realm as well.
You will control no one. No man and no spirit either.
Foolish boy. Has Maxwell's impudence rubbed off on you as well?
You can call me whatever you want. Do you have any idea how much your actions have tormented Rowan here? Any idea at all?
Jude, please.
You people think peace is some sort of right. You are mistaken. Peace is a luxury, not a right. Surrender yourselves into my service. That is your duty as my subjects.
You are beyond salvation.
I'm through wasting my time with you. Let's put an end to this right now. Share all of the mana absorbed by the Lance of Kresnik.
Once I believed that you and I were two friends who traveled along the same path in life. However, now it seems we've reached our journey's end.
With a philosophy like that, life must be convenient. But your beliefs have become a royal pain to all of us. They're just illusions of grandeur.
I can't believe that someone like this could be our king! It's time someone knocks some sense in you!
Jude, and Mila, and everyone! I have to protect my friends!
Up with his head! Up with his head!
Someone needs to put a stop to your ambitions! And that would be us!
Prepare yourself, Nachtigall!
Now I shall show you the power that will unite Rhys and Maxia! wish to fall from grace, then let it be by my hand.
Are you capable of such when your spear is dulled?
This spear has granted unity and resolve to this country, now and forever.
We shall see, old friend.
But enough talk! There is no greater language than that of war. Have at you!
Very well, so be it. It all ends here.
Indeed.
Please
wake up!
My head hurts!
All beginnings must end. Let it be. By my hand! Elemental mastery!
It's not over. It's time you know your place. Shadow the sky!
Noctigal, you have lost. I request that you stand down.
You fools, if you kill me, then you will be unwittingly handing Rashikal over to Gaius.
Regardless, as king, you must answer for your crimes.
Nonsense. With the Lance of Kresnik, I shall have absolute power!
That's enough. Mankind wasn't meant to wield such power. It would destroy the world as we know it. And you as well.
Mila, wait! This man is Rowan's friend, so Rowan should handle it.
Noctigal, a country without its king is doomed to chaos. You have turned away from the responsibility you must bear. We have both turned away. King Noctigal.
Ilbert, you're not saying that I should...
Let us build a new future for Rashigal together.
You mean you would bear the burden of my crimes as well?
It's of no consequence.
Rowan. Do it.
Yes, Master.
Noctigal! Who is it? Who's there?
No, they must be after...
The Lance of Kresnik!
Don't worry about me. We must hurry.
We're too late.
It's gone! Are you sure it was even here?
Noctigal absorbed the Lance's energy before fighting us. It had to have been here.
Gillen's gone as well. Maybe he moved it.
If the Lance made it outside, it could be anywhere by now. Let us leave the palace.
Halt! Identify yourselves!
Uh-oh. This ain't good.
Hey, hold on. Aren't you Chief Ilbert?
That is correct.
I have a message! Let me through!
What is it?
Azul's army is on the march! The enemy force is said to exceed 50,000 men!
The war... it started.
Order the troops to attack.
Forward to victory!
Forward to victory!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
Prepare to attack!
Forward to victory!
Forward to victory!
Prepare to attack!
Forward to victory!
From Sapstrath?
No, they're coming from north of Finmont. They're in Fezabel Marsh.
Impossible. How do they intend to march across such impassable terrain? The spirit climbs have stopped shifting.
Chief Ilbert, we are unable to decipher their method of transportation.
This is bad, isn't it? All our soldiers are concentrated in Fort Gundala and at sea.
At this point, we may not have time to move our troops into position.
You need not worry. Deputy Chief of Staff Gillen foresaw this attack. He is transporting our new weapon to the battlefield as we speak.
I knew it.
Soldier, who ordered you to carry this message?
The Deputy Chief himself. Is something wrong?
No. You are dismissed.
Gilland is up to something.
Whatever it is, we must head to Fezabel Marsh at once.
This library is spectacular.
It should be. Orda Palace is said to have the largest collection of books in all of Risa Maxia.
If I had the time to spare, I could spend decades here reading through it all. This is Men and Women Beneath the Sheets, Volume 4! The publisher said it was banned, and the entire print run destroyed. Something that's not even supposed to exist, just sitting here, like it's the most natural thing in the world.
And that's good?
We would never even consider the issue of whether it's good or evil if its existence had remained a secret. Should it be known, I am sure opinions would vary. But debating right and wrong is itself a part of culture. In fact, isn't free communication the very heart of all human culture?
I suppose that it is.
Great! Now that I know you understand, let's try reading a little.
Let's do that some other time.
Identify yourselves. State your names, ranks, and divisions.
I am Rowan Ilbert, Chief of Staff, Rashagal Army.
The Ilbert? As in the conductor?
Correct. I wish to be briefed at once regarding our troop strength and deployment.
Yes, sir. Please proceed.
This table creates a tactical diagram of the battle by reading signals from the soldiers' Lilium orbs.
Hey, how come this one looks different?
That division is taking part in a special operation being led by the Deputy Chief of Staff himself. Agria of the Chimeriad attempted to block them, but it appears they broke through.
Gillen's operation?
Yes. He should arrive at the operation site a little after 1300 hours. We've been given no details, although we hear this operation will turn the tide of battle in one fell swoop. We've been ordered to concentrate as many troops as possible around that site when the operation commences.
With this route, his destination must be here, correct?
Yes, sir. Precisely. I should have expected nothing less from the conductor.
I do not like where this is heading.
Yes. No doubt he has plans to use the Lance of Kresnik. Yet why did he leave his own army in the dark?
You think we can catch up to them before they use the Lance?
I don't know. I hope so.
I stole the key required to activate the Lance. I entrusted it to Ivor.
We figured that would be enough to stop anyone from using it.
Nevertheless, it has been deployed, and they are likely readying it for use. That can only mean one thing.
They may have created a new key.
How is the Azul army marching across the marshes? I don't believe Renom ever arrived.
Are you familiar with the boosters that Azul has developed?
Hey! Quit staring at me like that! I hate being objectified!
The enemy is using them to amplify their mana output and alter the spirit climb in their immediate area.
In other words, they use mana to summon vast amounts of Earth spirits and force the spirit climb into Renom. They've actually changed the seasons. A brilliant strategy. One only Wingull could have conceived.
How has Roshigal responded?
We too have boosters.
So you issued one to every soldier, and assigned one man in every squad with the job of altering the spirit climb.
Yes, sir. Exactly as you said.
That sounds like a job for us, Elise!
No, this is Rowan's turf. He's an expert in the use of Earth arts.
We have no time. We must intercept Gillen's division. Might I borrow one of your spare boosters?
Chief Ilbert, there's one thing I should mention about the boosters. We keep hearing rumors that their use leads to a serious side effect.
Which is?
They say prolonged use saps your strength.
You mean it leeches away your very life?
The severity of this effect seems to vary wildly among those afflicted. Just to be safe, I suggest you avoid using the booster for long periods.
Alvin?
You sure you want to be standing out there in the rain?
Wait, what? But I swear I heard you from over here.
Say what? You hit your head or something?
Making up lies again?
Jeez, Elise, give me a break.
I'll give you a break, all right, you big fat liar!
You ready to string me up too?
Come now. Given the circumstances, it's only natural for us to become suspicious when you wander off on your own.
Just stick close to us from now on.
Seriously, promise us!
Fine, fine.
Everyone, stay close to me.
It's hard to see anything. The enemy could be anywhere.
Maybe we should try to find a safer route.
No, we don't have time for that. We just need to charge straight through.
Hold on! This sounds like suicide!
Well, we'll be okay. Jude says so.
Don't be afraid. We have nothing to fear but failure. The fate of humanity and spirit kind hangs in the balance.
Nice! I'll have to write that one down.
Let's go, everyone.
We will destroy the Lance of Kresnik. Don't stop for anything else.
I'm here!
It's over! Deep breath!
Burn!
Deep breath! It's over! Watch out!
Huh?
What are you doing? We're on your side!
Save it! We've received orders directly from Deputy Chief of Staff Gillen. Conductor Ilbert has defected to the enemy and must be stopped by any means necessary, including lethal force.
What?
We won't let you destroy the cornerstone of Rajagal's strategy!
Why did it have to come to this?
Gillen obviously wants us dead. That is not particularly surprising given his past track record.
You know how it is. You want something bad, the end really justifies the means.
Although, I'm starting to believe victory is not his ultimate goal.
I have a bad feeling about all this.
Yeah, let's hurry on.
Let's make this quick.
I'm right here with you, Mila.
How can you keep putting your life in danger like this? Don't you realize you'll throw everyone's lives into chaos if you end up dying?
Hey, what's that?
Nothing. Better stay focused on the battle.
I'll take them down, no matter what!
Hey, you're pushing yourself too hard. Fall back and rest.
I'm okay.
Alvin's right. We still have a ways to go.
I told you, I'm fine. Let's just focus on our task, please.
All right. I'm glad you're on our side, too. I'm counting on you.
I have your back. Don't worry, I can do this.
When will this end? It's so damn close.
Hey, are you okay?
Come on. This isn't enough to take me down.
Alvin, are you sure you're all right?
Would I lie at a time like this?
Well, I don't know.
That part of me is gone.
I'm sure that's a lie.
Gotta be serious sometimes.
Hey, come on, guys. Less talking, more fighting.
Okay, it's over.
Protect me, okay? There's more?
We're so close.
Are you all right, Kira? But this is war. It's nothing but a sight that cuts down the dreams and lives of our youth. I take no pleasure knowing most of my years were on the battlefield. And despite my efforts, the travesty continues.
Rowan, you can't give up. You'll find a way to stop all of this.
You're right, of course. Our destination is just up ahead. Let us make haste.
Damn it! Just leave us alone already!
If only battles could be ended by simply asking.
We can always wish!
This is so rough!
Don't worry. I got your back, Elise.
No one asked for your help.
You should be alright with that much energy.
Out of my way!
Leia, don't rush forward lest you be completely surrounded.
Things are not looking good, Mila.
I know, but we can't retreat. We must keep pushing onward.
Hang in there!
You too, Pete.
I'm not giving up.
You hear that? None of us will give up.
Together, the spirits
can you still keep up?
Of course.
Gilland?
Doesn't look like it. It's the Chimeriad.
More troops? They'll make us late for our rendezvous with Agria.
Doesn't bother me. Let us at him, Wingo. Pretty please.
That man in the back in the red armor. He's the king of this particular chessboard.
Understood.
There are only three of them.
Take them out!
He leads from the rear.
And off he goes, rushing in again. Not that I mind. You're out of your depth.
Get the woman! Stop her!
Nice to get the blood boiling for a change.
Checkmate. Although this king was no better than his pawns. So you've come, Maxwell.
It appears we must face each other on the battlefield after all. What a sad end to this tale.
Thanks for wasting our time with that search in the mountains.
My pleasure.
Have you taken out Gilland?
I don't have to answer that.
Then let's change the subject. Step aside so we can pass.
I don't think so.
We will destroy the Lance. With it gone, Azul's victory is assured. Why keep us from our task?
It is the will of His Highness.
This battle is merely a stepping stone toward our true goal.
But it is an unnecessary step. One that could cost your lives. Who would be left to support the king?
His Highness can look after himself.
Unlike some people, he would never fight feebly from the rear.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Don't play dumb, Chief Ilbert. You were meant to lead, not hide. It was your duty to fight, not carry the rear. Noctigal became a tyrant because of your inaction. Your only recourse was to stain your hands with his blood.
Word spreads fast.
That wasn't Rowan's fault. Noctigal was responsible for his own actions.
Do not pass the blame. Individual fault is a petty thing when weighed against the good of a nation.
What do you mean?
The people need a leader to guide them. Otherwise, they will go astray.
Rowan is fully capable of handling that.
It is not that simple. I am just a military strategist. I'm unworthy of the throne.
But our king is.
And he has seen the path he must take to lead the people.
The Lance lies on that path. We will take it and add it to his power.
Don't make me say it again. We won't hand over the Lance of Kresnik, no matter what your reasons are.
And I won't let you interfere with Mila's... with Maxwell's mission.
Aua! Now good on standing!
Ready yourself.
So be it.
Everyone, stay sharp.
Yeah!
Stand down, it's too dangerous!
No, I won't!
Don't get mad with these guys.
Now that's not very nice.
Let no one to talk.
It doesn't matter who stands in our way. We will carve our path forward.
No! No! It's not worth it!
No! No!
Farewell! Let me do it!
Farewell!
Act as one unit!
Defend it!
Okay!
Ruination phase!
It's over!
Dragon
Mare Claw!
Rolling attack! Nice job! Rolling attack!
Go!
Square ball!
Okay!
Zoom to Nexia!
This
one's
not me!
We're on the top! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
unfortunate.
Get him! Please keep them away! Right on point!
Let's burn!
It's not working?
You're lying!
It's over!
Fist it! Zoom to Nexia!
Look out! It's over! Look out!
Get right on me! Don't
as expected from the Chimeriad.
Can't imagine fighting them all at once.
We'd still win, no matter what.
That's right.
As long as Mila's around.
Wingle, where is your booster?
Right here.
You were willing to go that far to serve Caius.
Sorry. I'm not interested in any last words.
Alvin! The battle's over!
Fine. I'll let her go, if you insist.
This is really how you live your life, huh? I'd watch your back around him. He's just playing with you now. And someday, he'll throw you away.
I'd like to think Alvin knows how I feel.
I have to know. Why do you seem to care so much about me?
Speak up, big guy!
Why won't you tell me? Hey, it's okay.
The Lance of Kresnik is just ahead. I know you all have a lot on your minds. But I must push onward.
Caius!
So, you defeated the Chimeriad.
I cannot say I'm surprised you came to the battlefield yourself.
Of course. It is my path.
Answer me. Why do you want the Lance of Kresnik?
With it, I will protect the people of this world. I shall gather all such sources of power and place them under my safe control.
There is a fine line between protection and domination. The Lance will become the bane of the very people you seek to protect. This path of yours will lead to ruin.
Preposterous. I will never falter as long as I have this will to guide the weak.
Yet you have overlooked one crucial fact.
And that is?
Despite your power and that will of yours, someday you will die. Then what? Can you guarantee that whomever inherits the Lance will share your vision and your will? Eventually, those who follow will succumb to the Lance's unfathomable power. They will destroy your legacy and themselves. It's just human nature. Your history proves this.
Then I will chart a new path for history.
In the end, you too show yourself to be human.
Of course. And it's because I'm human that I yearn for a united Risa Maxia. But I suppose you see it as only greed and ambition.
Caius, for the last time, I will not give you the Lance. Will you stand down?
Never.
I thought you might understand. But regardless, the Lance of Kresnik must be destroyed.
Yes. For the sake of future generations.
We need to end this here and now! Yes! We can't stop now!
We'll stand by Mila!
I think you know what happens next.
We will prevail.
Show me your resolve.
Guys, in the name of the Great Spirit.
think you can handle us alone?
I think you're underestimating us.
You're all getting ahead of yourselves. Witness what humans are truly capable of.
You don't scare us!
Awaken! The Inferno cries out into oblivion! Absolute domination!
Look out!
Mila!
Not over yet!
Incineration wave!
All beginning must end. Let it be by my hand.
Elemental mastery.
Is this it?
Know this: I will not be so easily defeated.
And you are no less than I expected. Nevertheless, the Lance of Krasnik shall be mine!
Uh-oh, I don't like the look of that.
Damn it. Where is he?
Farewell. Who dares?
Ivor to the rescue!
Ivor? Why are you here?
Lady Mila, once your powers are restored, you'll be able to give that pretender serious smiting!
What are you doing?
Pay attention, Jude! I'll show you what separates the handmaids from the boys! The power of the four great spirits shall be revived!
So, I was mistaken all along. And that means that the lance was never a weapon at all.
Mila?
is going on?
Gilland! What is going on?
You're telling me that's Gilland?
Damn it. You son of a...
Were you the one who attacked Hamill?
Yes. That was the handiwork of my spirit Celsius.
Spirit Celsius? I've never even heard the name before.
You dared lay hands on my people. For that, you will pay!
That's the woman, right over there.
What? Exodus? Were you the one who told Nautical about Spyrek?
Don't kill that woman. Would ruin everything.
Mobile armored units, forward!
Yes, sir!
Not paying attention. Stand pretty and stay out of this.
Miss Elise!
Bring the brat along, too. A fine specimen of booster compatibility.
Take your hands off of her! Oh. Why are you doing this?
Go to sleep. You'll just complicate things.
Gaius!
We will settle our score later. Maxwell is the one they're after. Take her and flee! What do you think you're doing? I told you to go!
But we can't just leave Elise!
Rowan, Leia, take care of Mila. You all go on ahead.
Your Highness!
Come now, child. Open your eyes.
Hey! What's a big idea, big guy? Let Elise go right now!
I have a confession to make, and an apology. About your parents. The bandit who killed them. It was me.
Huh? Please!
I'm afraid I will no longer be able to protect you. Forgive me, child, and live on.
Joe, why not?
I want you to protect Elise for me.
Thank you for your faithful service.
Look after everyone. It's time for one last rampage!